hope the girls are all right.
Matt. You naive fucking brat. You thought that'd be the end? You thought you'd meet with our good old friend and it would all be over? You thought you'd get off the hook so easily? That we're as naive as your poor, stupid Ellen? Maybe you thought you'd hit us in the face and we'd shut up? Matt, understand this already. This is not the end. This is barely the beginning. We're coming.
Where is everybody? God, they're here. I just need to find the surgical ward. Thank you.
losing hope. I think Mom doesn't even want to have any. She comes to the hospital less and less. The doctors say it's still too early to make any drastic decisions. But Mom, she says we need to make a life without you. That it'll be better that way. I'm scared, Dad.
What's going on here? Huh? Am I in hell?
If you're reading these words, then I'm already gone. I lost to the disease, and apparently we weren't meant to meet again before my death. Was that an accident, or was it your choice, your punishment for me? Well, this is where you probably expect me to apologize and beg your forgiveness. You couldn't be more wrong. You and your mother were always so pathetic. Incompetent. I always felt you held me back. You sucked all the energy out of me. I tried to love you, Matthew, really, as God is my witness, but I couldn't. You were a burden to me, a ball and chain I couldn't get rid of. The same for your fucking mother. She always, always had to get her 2 cents in. She just wouldn't shut up. I'll tell you honestly, Matt, once I realized you really weren't coming, that was the first time I was ever proud of you. For the first time, instead of being the weakling you've always been, you acted like a real man. So, here's the thing. Do you know why I wanted you to come? Obviously, not so I could see your shit wife and stupid kid. I needed a donor, Matthew, and I hoped you'd be the reliable pussy that lets others push him around, as always. That's all I wanted from you. for you to give me a piece of yourself in exchange for some of those sweet lies you always wanted to hear from me. Maybe someone will make a man out of you yet. Well, at least I won't have to deal with it anymore. Goodbye, Matt. Father.
No. 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 Please. Please, God, I'm fucking begging you. This can't be true. It's not true. I need to see the bodies. Maybe there's been some mistake. I'll go to the morgue. I need to see them.
hear us. Damn, that went to shit really quick, huh? You see, you don't even have to come to us. We're always with you, always have been. We won't leave you for a second. Remember the first time you hit Ellen? She got mad at you for drinking too much. Yeah, we were there. Or when you got so hammered you pass out in a pile of garbage bags in front of the bar. Yeah, we were there too. Fun times. Well, we're always with you, Maddie. We won't leave you for a second.
That means that Anne and Ellen.
I've made a decision, Matt. Actually, I've made two very fucking difficult decisions. And you know what? I've made them without you. Without hearing your constant drunken bullshit, how you always have it so hard, how we should always listen to you, how you want what's best for us. I had to explain your last best at work as a fucking cycling accident. I've had enough, Matt. I'm exhausted. I know somewhere deep down I still know that you didn't want this. But who you became? The doctors say that after all the time that's passed without you getting better, I can make a decision. And I think this is that moment. We've long passed the line beyond which we should have said goodbye to each other.